Context-free grammar CFG have four components. I think you remember. What are these? Those four components you had studied. It had epsilon. Can anybody say what is epsilon? Can anybody say? Yes, this is alphabets. So these alphabets can be look like A to Z, small a to Z. It can be capital A to Z. Usually in TOC we don't write, because in TOC capital letters are reserved for non-terminals. But here we can put here also. Okay. Then if you may have digits 0 to 9, and if it is binary, you may have only 0 and 1. Okay. For some language you have say define which can have only A and B as alphabet, nothing else. Okay. Then you have B. B is, who can say? B is set of variables. See, these things are, I should, I must write them, that they are finite set of symbols. Okay. So otherwise you must understand, remember this, these are set, okay, and these sets are finite set. Okay, so here you can say variable, or you can say these are non-terminals. Right. So as per our this previous example, what I had shown you, it can be any string, any identifiers, right? I better do not write identifier. In the previous example, we have written like expression. Then what we have written? We have written something, statement. Okay. And if you just want to exclude these capital letters from alphabets for the time being, then you can have this A to J or capital letters there. Okay. So, but you have to be very mindful of where you are putting this A to J. This is quite optional in compiler design, because when you write programs, we use capital letters also. Okay. So that is what we have to remember. So alphabets are also can be called as terminals. Okay. Okay. So alphabets can also be called as terminals. Next is P. P is what? This is a set of definitely finite set of production rules. Okay. So a grammar must have a set of production rule, like you can have E to E plus T. Okay. So here these capital letters are representing variables, definitely. Okay. So this can be a production rule. So this kind of production rule must be there. And S is not a set. Okay. S is not a set. It is a unique symbol one grammar must have, called as start symbol or starting variable. Understand? So this is what about context free grammar. And another thing we must remember that in context free grammars, the production rules are always in this form. That means it is having head one arrow, then body of the rule. Okay, so the head is always a single variable. Okay, in this side you never have multiple variable or expression, never have. Okay, always the single variable will be there, and in the body part it is optional. Okay, it can be combination of non-terminals and terminals. Okay, so it can be generated by this union this. Okay. So I think what is context free grammar is clear. Now here is an example of context free grammar: list to list plus digit, list to list minus digit, list to digit, and digits are 0 to 9. So who can tell me what are the variables here? If I ask you to write V, so what are the variables are there in this grammar? Can anybody answer this? Hurry on. Yeah, somebody written Shomo. His answers are list and digit. So anybody else is having any something else or some other answer? No. So here in this grammar, these are the production rule P. Okay, so we have variable list and digit. Okay, now can somebody tell me what are the alphabets are there in this grammar? Or non-terminals? What are the non-terminals that are here? Charmi said 0 to 9. Anything else who differs from Charmi? Or who want to modify the answer? Are you sure no one want to modify this answer? Shubham, the same answer I don't want.
So there should be an empty character as well. I mean,
no, empty character here, it is not visible.
So in the
we don't have a rule with
have
empty character.
So, but in the second line, we have list minus digit.
We have digit, so yeah. List of digits 0 to 9, simple.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, Hariam came to the point. We have two more symbols here. One is the plus sign, another is the minus sign. Correct? So what I had told you, how to identify whether something is a alphabet or non-terminal or terminal. If something is not drivable, okay, it is going to stop the growth of the tree, simply. Okay, then plus is a symbol and minus is another. Okay, they are going to be treated as non-terminal. All right. Okay. So, next. Yeah. And what is the start symbol here? List and digit was here. And start symbol, yeah, somebody immediately answered is list. So correct, Hariyam given another correct answer. List is the start symbol. Because if you look this set of production rule P, then you can understand that you have to start with list, then you expand your tree, correct? Now, you have been given a string or expression, whatever you want to say, better call string right now, okay? And you have given set of production rule P. Now, can you generate, can you drive it? Who can show me a derivation tree for this? Just a minute, let me generate a form here in the classroom so that you can immediately upload your answer. Okay, so you just for that you just try to draw this tree, derivation tree on your copy. Okay, I am giving you upload option so that you can immediately upload it and I can see your answer. Okay. So only image you can upload here. Okay, I am giving this limitation. Okay, so you go to your classroom. Okay, I see. Okay, in your classroom, if you go to classwork, you will find QA in class, question answer in class. Okay, if you click on that, you will get a Google form on which you can click. Somebody has uploaded also something. No. Share the form. I didn't understand. Some mail was coming or what?
So it was a mail, I guess.
So try to upload to that form, okay? Whoever is drawing this, okay. Hey, what is going on? You people are doing what?
So those are the submissions.
Those are the
Those are the
submission.
submission.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
I understand. I understand.
Okay.
Then, but I heard it is showing zero responses.
The form needs access to upload. It's a closed form.
Access I have given. Let me check again. Oh no, sorry. Okay, I have given access. Now you upload. Sorry. Still now you are not getting access.
Accessible, sir.
Okay. Or you can share your screen and you can show in that another. Somebody just Amardeep Sinha, you have written the sequence of the revision you will do. One response is good, charming. Let me see what you have responded. What is your answer? You have done, Charmi, your tree is wrong, okay? This is not tree. That is the, this is why I am asking to do yourself. Charmi, your tree is not correct. No other response, I don't see any more responses. So, should I show the answer myself? Or anybody is want to
Just
upload the answer.
I am sending it.
Yes, sir, uploading.
Okay. Where is Nitish Kumar? Nitish Kumar, I want to see your answer. I think 20 times you have clicked on this access request. That means you have your answer ready. Rishabh. Rishabh, your answer is wrong. Anybody else? Nishit, Nitish, have uploaded. Let me see. Nitish is correct, but this long lines you have drawn, that is looking bad actually. Okay. However, your answer is right. But you don't do this long lines. Okay. On the right side, from plus to plus and digit to two. Digit to two is okay. Plus to plus, you should not do like this. Okay. Then it will cause deduction of some marks. So, okay. I don't want any more answer. Two more answers are there. Let me check immediately and move with. This is who Shubham. Shubham, your answer is correct. And then Sandeep. Sandeep, very messy. It looks it is also correct, yeah. All right, then good. Many of you have responded and answered. Okay. So, just a minute. Yeah. Okay, so this is done. So let me show you what correct answer people have given. So see, our starting symbol here is least. So put least at the root. Then see, what we have 9 minus 1, if we see the first operator as a deciding rule, which rule to choose. See, this rule is having plus and this rule is having minus sign. Okay, so is my screen is visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so we have two things here to decide. Here we have another, if you see this part, 5 plus 2 we have, and this part, 9 minus 1 we have. So it depends that which one we will go with. Now, as plus is having higher priority, let's put the plus, choose the plus, the rule with plus sign first. Okay. So still now we don't have any concrete what can I say? Justification, why I'm choosing it. Later, definitely, I will give you concrete justification. Okay. So, this rule is going to give us digit. Okay. Now, this list can be again further expanded using this rule, rule number 2. So, this one was happened using rule number 1. So I can expand this using rule number 2. Rule number 2 is having negative sign or minus sign here. So we put the minus sign. And this is least minus digit. Okay. Now I need here 9. Right under this first list. So here we have a second rule we had applied here. Okay. Now here from this list we need to lead this derivation to 9. Correct. So we have the third rule list to digit. So do it. So we have applied the third rule here, okay, and according to fourth rule, the digit can be anything from 0 to 9. So I can do 9 here, okay, and here we have already digit, so digit can be 5 also, so put 5 here, and this digit, so these are happening using rule number 4. So this digit can be derived to 2. Okay. So our derivation, if you only read the leaf nodes, then what is it giving? 9 minus 5 plus 2. Right. 9 minus 5 plus 2. So it is done. So this is what is the derivation tree. I think clear to all. I think it is clear to everyone. Okay. So let's move for the next part. Okay. This is parsing. So yeah, before I go to the next part, let me tell you this derivation, generation of this thing, this derivation tree, basically done by parsing. Okay, so parsing is the method which is going to help us to generate this kind of tree. Okay.
Excuse me.
So, yeah.
Sir, is this derivation tree unique, or there can be other trees for the same expression?
Yeah, there can be other tree. That is another issue I will come. Okay. That is called ambiguity. Okay. So parsing is a problem of taking a string of terminals and figuring out how to drive it from start symbol of the grammar. You understand? So still now we was calling it as derivation, right? Now we will call it as parsing. The same thing, same the derivation problem here we are going to call as parsing. But when we was doing derivation, there was no particular algorithm we can follow. Like, you know, somebody just now told me that it may not be unique. So if it is not unique, then what to do? That will be taken care by the parsing, the parsing algorithm, what we are going to discuss in coming chapters. Okay. If it cannot be derived from the start symbol of the grammar, then reporting syntax error within the string. That means when you are going to trying to generate this tree starting with the start symbol, if you are getting a failure, you are going to, you know, say I give you a string, say 9 multiplication 5 plus 2, okay, and I ask you, you generate a derivation tree or parse this string. So we call this as a string. Yeah. You parse this string using this set of production rule. Then what will happen? Yeah, you will definitely start with, you will definitely start with list. Okay. Even you can try with list plus dizzy, but after that you will need here a multiplication, and there is no rule out of this 4 where you have a multiplication as a symbol. So you are going to get failure. So your parsing will the parser will send you an error that there is something syntax error or some mistake in the syntax. Then you will go back and find out what is not supported by my grammar. And if you have the grammar detail, you will understand that this is not supported by this grammar. Okay, so that is what it is.